If you had a superpower of learning any new skill fast and efficiently, you could become a genius. You may notice that there are some people who may seem to be geniuses. They are not only masters in their fields, but basically whatever they do it extremely well. Have you ever wondered why? What differentiates them from 90% of other people who aren't particularly good at anything and have difficulties in learning new skills? What's their secret? Do they have any superpowers? The answer is that they simply know how to gain new skills. And science explains this phenomenon. I found out that there are some scientific-based techniques that can transform anybody from an average learner who spends hours on rereading definitions only to forget them a couple minutes later, to a genius who can learn any new skill much faster and be able to actually use new knowledge in real life. When I was younger, I didn't really know how to learn new skills. I didn't know about those powerful tactics that I'm gonna share with you in this video. The only thing I had was a strong desire to learn new things and curiosity. But unfortunately, that's very often not enough. You need the right strategies to be able to learn new skills like a pro. They can help you to learn any new language much faster, to memorize better new information for your tests so you can become a top student. You can use them for your job or business, or you can use them to become whoever you want, like a YouTuber, for example. Warning! The strategies that I'm gonna present to you are very powerful. They are based on cognitive psychology and neuroscience. They will help you not only learn faster, but also forget less. So your life will no longer be the same after watching this video. Number one, avoid popular methods. Recently, I've read a book, Make It Stick, by Peter Brown, Henry Rodriguez, and Mark McDaniel. According to this book, the most common study techniques are actually the worst ones. 90% of people, when they want to learn something, they either highlight it or reread it. And it just cannot work to efficiently learn new information, and there is science behind it. First of all, it is because highlighting and rereading are passive activities. Simply going over the material or marking the text with a highlighter does not necessarily engage your brain actively in understanding the concepts, so it doesn't make you process information. The second reason is that it only gives you an illusion of knowledge and competence. Rereading can create a false sense of familiarity with the material. Just because you've seen the information before doesn't mean that you've truly learned it or understood it. An example of this can be when you try to learn new vocabulary in a foreign language from a list of words. It's not only boring and time-consuming, but also, according to science, ineffective. That's why you should forget about those popular methods. And here is what to do instead. Number two, retrieval. The authors of the book Make It Stick propose a solution. And it is to introduce into your learning a retrieval practice. In seminar study, participants were given a material to study, and then they were tested by either restudying or retrieving it. Researchers found that retrieval practice improved long-term retention compared to restudying. Retrieval refers to the process of recalling or bringing to mind previously learned information from memory. It involves actively pulling information from memory, rather than passively reviewing material. There are many ways of how you can practice retrieval, like active recall, testing, or applying your knowledge in real life. You can practice it by using self-quizzes, flashcards, or actively recalling key concepts. Retrieval is not about just memorizing facts, but actually applying new knowledge in a context. Solving problems, answering questions, and explaining concepts to others are forms of active retrieval. Before we move to the third point, if you like this video and if you wanna see more of my videos in the future, consider subscribing. Number three, Feynman Technique. The Feynman Technique is a four-step learning method that was originally introduced by an American Nobel laureate, Richard Feynman. The main idea behind this method is to take a concept that is hard to understand and clarify this in your mind to the point that you would be able to explain it to the child. The key four steps to use this technique are: number one, select a concept to learn. You probably know what you need to learn, so let's move to the second point. Number two, teach it to a child. Explaining complicated concepts in an easy manner shows that you really processed information. When you struggle to explain a new concept clearly, you know where your knowledge is lacking. Teaching a concept often reveals gaps in your own understanding. Albert Einstein once said, "If you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it well enough." Number three, review and refine your understanding. This is what many teachers do. They often have to repeat the same information all over again, and it helps them to strengthen it in their memory. Number four, organize your notes and revisit them regularly. Make a note of your simple explanation. Writing helps to clarify your thoughts, and it also adds reflection to learning. What I like about Feynman technique is that it gives you a boost of motivation to learn new things. If I know that I have to explain a new idea to someone, it gives me an external motivation to master it in the first place. On the other hand, if you just have to memorize information or read it, you aren't really forced to process it and fully understand the idea behind words. Number four, dual coding. Dual coding is the cognitive learning theory introduced by Alan Pavio in the 1970s. The theory explains that the information is processed and stored in two different systems: a verbal system for processing language-based information and non-verbal system for processing visual and spatial information. According to dual coding theory, when the information is presented in both visual and verbal formats, it is more likely to be encoded and retained in memory. You can use dual coding in pretty much everything, also in language learning. I often listen to an audiobook and look at the text at the same time. And thanks to that, I can learn at the same time the right spelling and pronunciation. And the good thing about it is that you can actually practice it on any level. Number five, lifelong learning. Lifelong learning is a form of self-initiated education that is focused on self-development. It is a form of learning that occurs outside of a formal educational institute, such as school or university. We all, to a certain point, experience lifelong learning because we have to adapt to new circumstances constantly. But what if we actually treat this concept more consciously? Lifelong learning is about having a mindset of continuous learning. It's about staying open and curious about new information and new skills throughout your life. According to the book Atomic Habits that I often mention on this channel, you can change your habits for a lifetime only if you change your identity. Don't try to change, become a change. Don't try to learn, become a learner. A naturally curious person who wants to know more and explore new ideas and topics. Number six, learn to focus. There is one thing that you can be sure of. You can know about every single strategy that I mentioned in this video, but if you are unable to focus, you won't learn pretty much anything. According to my research, on average, human attention lasts from 10 to 20 minutes. And if you are addicted to platforms with short-form content, it may even decrease. And what skill can you really learn in 10 minutes? Maybe just some basic origami. And I mean very basic one. But if your ambitions are beyond that, check out the video that is visible on the screen. There, I share with you the strategies that will help you to stay focused for longer. Thank you for watching and see you there.